All right. So are any of these easy to answer right off the bat?
Well, one of them is really easy to answer right off the bat, and that's -1, -1.
Good.
Because that's one of the points. So if we just
Yeah. So the joint strategy to get the -1, -1 would be for both players to cooperate, right? Again, they're just willing to do that just for the sake of showing that they can make that value.
Right. And I think I know the answers for the other ones as well.
All right, hit me.
So here's how I'm gonna talk you through my reasoning so that at any point I'm wrong, you can gently steer me away from embarrassing myself. Basically, I was looking at these points and I thought, they form a kind of convex hull.
Aha.
And I thought, well, surely that's just an accident of the numbers. And then I thought, oh, wait, of course, we're talking about averages here. So that means that all sort of possibilities have to be inside the convex hull of the outer points. So if I drew a line between those four points, I would end up with all possible achievable averages.
Well, achievable averages how? How would you achieve things inside the convex hull?
I would appropriately average them. So in
Yeah.
particular, the first thing I noticed that -3, 0 is outside that. So it can't be something you can achieve.
Right. There's no way to make this -3, 0, certainly not by choosing any of these points, but also no convex combination, no probabilistic combination of them is going to do that either.
Right.
So this one is just right out.
Right. So that leaves -4, -4, and it seems pretty, that's inside the convex hull, so there is some combination of them that would work.
That's right. Any sense of what it would be?
Two-thirds, I think two-thirds DD, one-third CC. And I get that by noticing that D comma D is -6, -6, and C comma C is -1, -1, and -4 is two-thirds of the way between there.
Boom. Cool. All right. So you good with that?
I'm good with that. If you're good with that, it's your quiz.
No, I'm excited.
Oh,
Yeah,
good.
so those the, it's this the -1, -1, and the -4, -4 are doing it. And as you pointed out, there's a more general result here having to do with the convex hull.
Right.
All right, so through the magic of computer graphics, I have a slightly better depiction of this particular region now. As you pointed out, this convex hull of the points is really important, and what it represents is we can call it the feasible region. These are average payoffs of some joint strategy. They may have to collude to do this. And they may not be particularly ex happy to do that, but the fact of the matter is, they can achieve by working together payoffs anywhere inside this region.
So that's what my student Liam always meant when he talked about feasible regions.
Maybe so. I mean, it could be that he meant any of a number of other things, like places that he's willing to live when he goes to gets a job.
No, it was all game theory stuff. I just never knew what he was talking about. But
And
now I
I think
do,
it.
Michael, thanks to you.
Sure. Hey, I'm happy to help. So this is a really useful kind of geometric way of picturing something that would otherwise be a little bit harder to see, I think, in the matrix form.
Sure.